Great time, 11:53. Double lot. We're going to be. Oops. Wee. Checking out the. I'll be in 6-2-3. My brain's taking a shit because I'm being bothered right now. I apologize. Nebula. We're going to be checking out these two stars up here. We'll be in 63 sector JH-VC2-24 and PD-SB4-5. And for the fuck of it, we're going to be checking out maybe a couple more. Just close enough in the surrounding area. This little trail off area over here. See where it kind of turns hazy. So we'll probably be checking out this guy as well. We're probably gonna check out this guy. This one right here is a maybe. And we're probably gonna maybe be checking out this guy as well. But the reason we're gonna check these top two because this one's closest to it. Kind of being in it almost. Can't exactly tell because it's a shitty dot. But we're gonna check this one too, more specifically. Because the vortex that it kind of looks like it creates gets kind of cut out right here, and we see these kind of see that it maybe almost seems like it with the gravity of it maybe perhaps it started sucking in some of these elements that make up this. There are no system maps available for this one or this one, unfortunately. So my hopes is that there isn't, and we'll be able to scan everything in there and see what happens. We've got a T Tauri star, and we also have a Ham dwarf star. So it's an unusual regular sh well, it's not irregular, but it's a an unusual enough shape for it to be almost projecting out in a certain way. It's kind of hard to say. I would assume that it started here and blew outwards. This kind of looks like how that happened. So, want to check this out first because there might be some significant reason why. Maybe there's a black hole. A VA. I don't know what the fuck a VA is, but we'll eventually learn. Yay. Let's see if I can change how these look. Just our names. Boop, boop. Let's go to realistic. So. Bothered some more. I really don't care. Anywho. So, yeah, we're gonna go check that out. Currently in Maya. Super Cruise. We're probably far enough away from Maya B right now. But we have 14 jumps to that galaxy, pardon, to that nebula. So what I'm gonna do is see what the black hole looks like. What identifies it in the system map here, or in the galaxy map? Usually every star it writes what stars are in that system. So now this Maya B. Stars 20 masses or more. It's old as fuck. Cool. Catalog ID Hipparchus 17573 and HD 23408. So if you ever want to Google anything, in your free time, that's what the HIP stands for, is Hipparchus, and HD. I would have to look that reference up real quick, and I think I'm gonna do that and take a second. Boom. HD Star Catalog. Let's see what that stands for here. Henry Draper Catalog, it says. Henry Draper Catalog, published between 1918 and 1924, giving spectroscopic classifications of 225,300 stars, later expanded by the Henry Draper Extension, HDE, published between 1925 and 1936, gave classification of 46,850 more stars by the Henry Draper Extension Charts, HDEC. Dates back to early shit. Yay. There you go. Henry Draper and Hipparchus. I'm going to go over to the galaxy map here because it will take just half a second. See if we can identify Maya 3B on. No. A1 and a V. It's pretty bright. Ooh, no. That's where we're going to. Woo. Let's see here. Maya. It just tells you black hole. Straight up. So, B63, a TV, T8V, T1, a V, an M3, a VA, an L3, a V, black hole, a Y1. So those numbers mean something too, also. I actually have to, let's see what a B63 star is. Okay. Caps lock B3. B. Ooh, shit! I should have wrote a B63. B-type main sequence star. It looks like it's saying something about. So, radiuses and masses and such. So, let's see. We have luminosity classes that go all the way up to 9. So B6 is the radius of 3.56. Mass is 5.17 with their appropriated symbols. So. 2 to 16 times the mass of a soul. So, that's what that is. Yeah, the B-type stars, in general. It just tells you their different masses. And their masses are kind of like how you would look at luminosity. So if you have a negative luminosity, it's actually super bright, and if you have a positive luminosity, it's super dim. So if you had the same thing, like a B0, its mass is huge. It's B9, it's fairly small. And about a B2 is already half the size of a B1, approximately-ish. So all the way down to 9, so you can see kind of how there'd be an exponential sort of to that, kind of vague. I'd actually have to plot a dot graph, but we're fucking off out of here, and we're gonna be hitting the fucking highway. 14 jumps should be about 15 minutes, so go check out this nebula, and this is what this whole video is gonna be, maybe an hour. But what I really like about where we're going is you have all these big stars, California, your Witch Head. We're in Pleiades Nebula right now. Getting out of that, and We're going to one that's kind of small. If you look on the galaxy map, which I'll show eventually, probably when we get there, it's a little reminder that there's cool stuff to look at besides these big obnoxious nebulas, and because they're not cataloged through a star, fucking what the fuck's it called? A system map. I call it a star map. Of course, it's a star map. Through the system map that. Maybe somebody hasn't officially discovered it, so that's what we're gonna do. And it caught my attention on while I was in Maya looking at the black hole, and it just kind of I didn't know if it was a body. At first, I knew I scanned it, like I just did with my D scan. So when I have the Advanced Discovery Scanner, that's what D stands for anyone that's new and watching this. So I have the advanced one, and I knew I've scanned in that system like 3 times already, just to make sure. I do that every now and then, just to kind of like, oh, did I forget? And it never hurts to do it again because that doesn't do anything but scan. Doesn't. Why not? It doesn't hurt you in any way, so it's always good to make sure that one up, because then you can sell your cartographics. Yay! So I'm gonna go discover this nebula, hopefully be the first to discover it, and then sell those cartographics and have my own 2-star nebula. Woo! Yay! And if I call it a galaxy, I apologize, and if I don't catch it, obviously it's a nebula. So, I've been calling it a galaxy kind of over and over, and I keep fucking that up, and I do apologize. So, here we go. So, TTS stands for T-Tauri. These are like dwarf stars. So, we're off. D scan. So T Tauri star is see what the thing says. Named after their prototype. I don't know what their prototype is. Oh, our class of variable stars named after their prototype, T Tauri. And the T constellation Taurus. Sure, they're not all in Taurus, but discovered by find amongst the Hades cluster. Usually, you'll find them there too. But the Hades, Hades, and Taurus all form together in the same area, so. Very young, only a million years old. Consists of at least 3 stars, only which is visible. Oh, T Tauri is a visible star in the constellation. So there's a specific star named T Tauri also. So, but the T Tauri star is named after T Tauri. Optical variability and strong chromospheric lines. T Tauris are pre-main sequence stars. Pre-main sequence is loading. And yes, I'm reading. Stage has not yet reached the main sequence. So, the main sequence is. Continuous and distinctive band of stars that appears on a plot of stellar color versus brightness. These color magnitudes are known as Russell diagrams after their co-developers, Ejnar Hertzsprung and Henry Norris Russell. Standard known dwarf stars. So, it's pre-main sequence, so it's pre-dwarf, which means it's smaller than a dwarf star. That's what I'm assuming. But we're gonna just kick it right here and scoop some sweet fuel. They're the main sequence stars are your most numerous stars, that includes the Sol. Yay. Our very own home star. Whee! After a star is formed, it generates thermal energy in a dense core region through the nuclear fusion of hydrogen atoms into helium. During this stage of a star's lifetime, it's located along the main sequence at a position determined primarily by its mass, but also based upon its chemical composition and other factors. And all main sequence stars are in the hydrostatic equilibrium, where outward thermal pressure from the hot core is balanced by the inward pressure of gravitational collapse from the overlying layers. Strong dependence of rate of energy generation in the core on the temperature and pressure helps sustain this balance. Energy is generated at the core, makes its way to the surface, and is radiated away at the photosphere. Energy is carried by either radiation or convection, with the latter occurring in regions with steeper temperature gradients and higher opacity, or both. Yeah. Yeah. So, and think before that, before its life. Said the T-Tauri star itself is about 1 million years old, so. But pre-main sequence star is a star in stasis, not yet reached main sequence, either its life, earlier in its life, actually. The object is a photostar that grows by acquiring mass from its surrounding envelope of interstellar dust and gas. Protostar blows up the envelope, optically visible, and appears on the stellar birth line on the Hertzsprung-Russell diagram. And at this point, the star has acquired nearly all of its mass, but not yet started hydrogen burning, which is nuclear fusion of hydrogen. And the star then contacts its hydrogen burning on zero age main sequence. Period of contraction in the pre-main sequence stage. An observed pre-main sequence object can either be a T-Tauri star if it has fewer than 2 solar masses, or as a star, which call it a HABE by how it's written, shorthand, which is a pre-main sequence star. Less than 10 million years. Hydrogen and calcium emission lines are observed in the spectra. 2 to 8 solar masses. Sitting in the star formation, gravitational contraction stage. Pushing main sequence. So those are the two. It could be a T-Tauri or HABE, Herbig, AB star. 2 to 8. Yeah, more stars have no pre-main sequence stage because they contract photostar. And by the time they become visible, hydrogen in their centers is already fusing sequence objects. Just like y'all, we're just gonna eat all the energy. So, yeah, so that's T-Tauri star. It's a little fun fact about what those little guys do. Yeah. But what I want to do is look at some stuff about this nebula. And for the rest of the journey, just kind of talk about the little guy that I'm going to with all 2 of its stars. A peck of fatty. sit on here and scoop for a sec while I figure out the name again. It's 2 something 6. Burp. Bork bork. Yeah. LBN 623. Let's see what LBN stands for. I do not have any information. Alright, let's see what great and powerful wizard of Google says about this. So, M-class stars. Our star, our home star, Sol, is a G-type. O-B-A-F-G-K-M. O-B, fucking good killer, man. That's how you can remember that. Or whatever, that's how I remember it. O-B, a fucking good killer, man, is the order from hottest to brightest. So O is hot. You have wolf riots, which are hotter and brighter and bigger than that. But they're, we're talking about main sequence right now. Still, let's keep that as the trend, if you will. So OB, a fucking good killer man, or something like along that. Okay. I remember that, right? OBAF. Yeah, I think. This is a K class. And I'm not. Ooh, I don't think I've been D-scanning, and that makes me sad. So, D-scanning, it's your best friend. Ooh, fuck me. People have been out. Fuck. Alright, so. Somebody's already seen it, but we are looking at some fancy shit. Boop. Basic data. Right ascension and declination. Let's see if we can find its right ascension. If you were... raw deck. Yeah, where's... why is it not telling me 1.499? Bibliography. fuck me. It doesn't have really any information. This site sucks ass. Not to knock Sim bad. I don't know what the fuck that is. But. You have a lot of other commanders that have made catalogs. Coordinates -484, -22, and -328 are your XYZ, respectively. So, unfortunately, somebody else has discovered it. Maybe. Maybe not. Some people go out there and they don't even bring equipment. Or discoveries of any sort, and it sucks to be them, I guess. But let's hope. Sometimes we're making my way out to Sagittarius, so I was able to find stars that gave a reference of what's actually in the system. Data. Oh no, that's because I scanned it first. Gives me that. So. Why is it Slovenian? Why am I reading Slovenian? I want it in fucking English. Neighborhood. Region. Sinbad. Region. Interesting. Ooh, Santa Fe. I don't have cargo. I don't know why that guy said I had cargo. I don't. That's stupid. Boop. Can't really see it. Is that it? That might be it right there. Got another 5 minutes, so need to scoop. We're going to a what class? Let's look for wet. I don't think, oh, maybe I can. No, I cannot. Shift drive charging. See what a mess. LDN. Dark nebulae. Alright, let's see what that's. Control F. For LBN. No, don't. You dumb. Diffuse nebula. Alright, so diffuse nebula, sometimes inaccurately referred to as gaseous nebula, are clouds of interstellar matter, namely thin but widespread agglomerations of gas and dust. They're large and massive enough, frequently places of star formations. Thus generating big associations of clusters of stars. There's some of the young stars are massive and high energy can excite the gas nebula, mostly hydrogen shine. Such a nebula is called a nebula. Stars are not hot enough. Their light is reflected by the dust and can be seen as white or bluish reflection nebula. Nope. Nebula have additional reflection nebula component. Usually also contain dust. Most impressive example is the Trifidae Nebula M20 H2 regions. Diffuse emission nebulae are often called H2 regions. Woo! Because they are mainly consisted of ionized hydrogen. H2 numeral number after the element, which is H, of ionization. One would stand for neutral atoms. Two means first ionization. Hydrogen atoms have lost their single electron. And for other higher number ionization, higher numbers of lost electrons would be possible. So from here. Oh no, a cool little snapshot there. After some years, gas nebulae have been used up for forming stars and planets, or blown away by stellar winds. Young hot stars, newly born open star cluster, will remain. From physical viewpoint, nebula are in early stage of evolution clusters. So that might why collective mass behind it may have been a lot larger, and the stars behind would look like that nebula are collected and formed already. Go to the T-Tori. Let's get a D-scan in here real quick. I have not been doing it. It's pretty fucking cool looking. That is not a T-Tauri star. Oh, it might be just before pre-main sequence, though. Just before it becomes main sequence. That's bright enough. Alright, we have. Let's do another scan to make sure. This. Objects. Or is it just one? Let's see, galaxy map says. TTSA VA. Fly out a little ways from the star. See if we can get a better image. Still relatively close. Nifty. Cool, lame-ish, but you know, nothing else in there, but we're going to do, so we're going to check out this guy now, get a different perspective. shit. Blurp. And it's an M class, so we can scoop off of it before we start our way back. Showing. You see, light pollution plays a factor in how these things look. So we fly out a little ways, we'll probably get more distinct, vibrant colors. And we're going to go back to that other one we were just at. See if we can get a better view. Actually, let's look at this from the side. That's annoying as fuck, though. All those fucking lines, ugh. Let's go here and check it out from there. As you can see, it's like bright as fuck now, but we're gonna go to the sky and try and see if we can see the whole thing from that side. left. And there it is. So we're gonna fly closer to it. So pretty. Just having that issue. It's the black charges we've been seeing. Let's see if we can find another view. Relatively close. Check this one out. Joink. I'm just gonna pull straight up.
Fuel scooping. Fuel scoop disengaged.
30 objects. Ooh wee. There it is. Right there. Couple stars in this area. 30 objects is a lot actually. Let's see. Well, that brightens up. Let's see what's in the system. Say what that's made of. No. That's pretty. It kind of looks like Bowser's face. Merp. potato. It looks like a uterus. I'm just kidding. You can see Chris Kyle's face, kind of, in there too. Yes, I said it. Chris Kyle's face. He's wearing his hat and everything. Kind of in the middle of the screen there. Fancy. Let's see, how far away are we? Still about 6,000. Ish. Probably get a lot brighter too. Let's look. Oh shit, I didn't realize I 360'd already. Not all that bright. Still, where am I? But I'm gonna call that what it is. That broadcast, it's done. Yay, Cortana. You guys have a good night. Current time 12:40, 11. Cortana, stop broadcast.